Katia is a peaceful land at the foot of Mount Mampo. The people make a living through trading and farming. Vivian and Lance are two young women who trade in the town. Being of the same age and neighbors since childhood, they have become close friends, sharing everything with each other.
Have you sold a lot today, Lance? It's been okay. Wow! At this rate, you'll soon open a big shop and become a rich owner.
So until then, we will travel and explore the world together. Let's take a break. I made some delicious pastries today.
Huh. Wow, you're the best at baking.
Life went on peacefully like this until one day.
It's so heavy.
Are you all right, ma'am?
Let me help you!
Mm-hmm. Thank you, dear. You're very kind. I've just moved here. Life in my old place wasn't easy.
Oh, yeah.
But on my first day here, I met such a kind and beautiful girl. This must be a good start for me. I have nothing to give you, but these are flowers I've cut myself to sell. Please take them and make me happy.
Thank you, ma'am. These flowers are beautiful. I'm right over there. If you need anything, just call me. Don't hesitate.
Feeling happy after doing a good deed, the young girl cherished the flowers the old woman gave her like a treasure. Since placing the flowers in her room, she felt more cheerful and slept better.
Huh?
Why are you late so often lately? The sun is already high in the sky. You can't run a business like this.
Oh, I slept so well. It won't hurt to rest for a while, Vivian.
However, Lance's lateness became more frequent. Some days, she didn't wake up to sell her goods at all. In the town, Vivian started noticing something unusual. The bustling streets were now deserted. Few people were around, and everyone seemed to flock to the old woman's flower stall across the street.
Ma'am, I'd like to buy this bouquet.
No, you can only buy half of it. If you take all, what will be left for others?
Please be calm, everyone. I have enough flowers for the whole town. Here you go.
Meanwhile, Lance was lost in a dream world. She saw herself adventuring through magical land. And fulfilling her dream of becoming a wealthy shop owner, enjoying trips with her friend Vivian. Vivian grew suspicious of the mysterious old woman and decided to follow her one evening. She discovered a shocking truth.
Huh? Hurry up and make the poisonous flowers bloom more. We are close to success. Soon, this entire land will be engulfed in dreams.
Yes, mistress.
Sleep and die in your beautiful dreams. This beautiful land of Katia will be mine. And I will rule it all.
It turned out the old woman was not as pitiful as Lance thought. She was the evil witch Laverna. Years ago, she attempted to attack and take over the magical land, but was thwarted by the butterfly fairies. She was punished and lost her ability to use dark magic. However, she did not abandon her evil ambitions and chose Katia to carry out her plan. She poisoned the people, trapping them in endless dreams to take over the kingdom.
Oh no! What should I do now? Lance! Lance, wake up, wake up! What's wrong with you?
At this point, Lance and many townsfolk were deeply lost in their dreams. Vivian quickly took action, removing all the poisonous flowers from Lance's room and other homes in the town. With the strength and swiftness of a seasoned vendor, Vivian completed this task quickly.
Oh my! What has she done to Katia?
The witch Laverna had planted a giant poison flower behind the mountain. If it bloomed, its immense poison would make it impossible to stop her evil plan. Vivian acted swiftly to destroy the magical plant before it could bloom.
I'm sure this is the way.
I can't trust your pea brain.
Hey!
Hey, handsome guys, where are you going?
Handsome?
Ow! Focus, you idiot! We are looking for a tree. Purple flower, tree, this tall. Have you seen it?
Oh, how could I not? It's so outstanding and beautiful. Two of you go to the road ahead and turn right to get there.
Is that so? Let's go.
Thank you, beautiful lady.
The two fools didn't realize they had fallen into Vivian's clever trap. The next morning, Laverna woke up, confidently stepping out into the street as if she owned Katia. But the immediate truth shocked her.
What strange thing is happening here? Why is it like this?
Dear Master, I did exactly as you said.
Why is it like this? I already know everything. You have taken advantage of my kindness and the compassion of all the people in this town to harm everyone. Is there anything you can't argue with?
It turned out the flower Vivian directed the foolish minions to was the pine flower, which closely resembled Laverna's poisonous flower. So, instead of spreading poison, the minions filled the town with fragrant flowers. When the main poisonous plant was destroyed, its harmful scent was neutralized, allowing Lance and the townspeople to wake up.
Lock her up! Don't let her harm other lands!
Yes, lock her up!
That deceitful witch, lock her up!
Mm-hmm.
From then on, Lance realized that to achieve dreams, one must wake up and work hard instead of getting lost in fantasies. The two girls and the townspeople return to their normal lives, working diligently each day to make their dreams come true.
Once upon a time, in the icy kingdom of Iceland, there lived a beautiful princess. The king and queen loved the princess very much. The princess loved to play and have fun all the time. She has so much energy that it could make her parents worry.
Mm-hmm.
Lisa! Lisa! Princess Lisa disappeared.
Quickly, go find Princess Lisa.
This wasn't the first time something like this had happened. Princess Lisa loved to ski, and she was having a great time enjoying the first snow of the season. Lisa, where have you been? You caused so much trouble. I told you not to leave the castle. Mom, I'm not a baby anymore. I'm fine. Why do you always worry? Do you want me to stay inside all day?
That's right. It's time it was Straker with you. Hand it over. You will never play ice skating again.
Dad, this is so unfair.
This is an order.
My parents don't understand me at all. I feel like I can't do anything I want. Why did they have to do this on my birthday? They worry about all sorts of things. If it was that easy to stop me, I wouldn't be friends with Lisa.
Princess?
Princess! Hi everyone, keep going. Let's get started.
Wow!
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 Wow! The fun and excitement of the first snow of the season didn't last long. Soon, trouble came from Wenlock, a bad wizard who had once been the fear of many young girls.
Huh? What is that? Oh my god!
Huh? What is that? Oh my god!
Lisa!
Huh? What's going on?
Wow! That's the most beautiful girl I've seen in this area. Hey, pretty girl! Where have you been hiding all this time?
Huh? Who are you?
Come on! You should know that. If you haven't met me yet, let me introduce myself. I'm Erika, the most charming man on the planet. I'm going to be your husband soon.
Husband? Please watch your words.
I will give you a once in a lifetime chance to be my wife. No, stay away from my daughter. Oh, my most father-in-law. It's been a long time. 16 or 17 years. She's your daughter. My relationship with you is impressive.
Haha. Please, please go away. Please forgive her.
Go away, Wenlock. You're ordering me around, old man. Have you forgotten what happened to your eldest daughter?
Huh? Eldest daughter? Do I have a sister?
Go away. You already have a wife. That's right. I've had 3 wives already. But none are as beautiful as her. It's time for me to have a new wife, and your daughter is the lucky one.
I don't think so. No way.
Well, the answer is wrong, but I will give you a new chance. Freeze them now.
No, stop!
Freeze them all.
No, no, you can't do that.
Hey, but I just did that. Last chance to make up for this. Marry me and we release all of them. How about it?
But...
Tick! I don't like waiting.
Lisa was confused and didn't know what to do. She hated Wenlock, but she couldn't let her parents and people be in danger. Hold on tight, Lisa!
No need to chase after me. Only ladies need to chase after me. The princess is coming back soon, but I give you 3 days before the magic spell lasts forever.
I have to go back. I can't live like that. We have to stop him. You can't. No one can. Why? Who is he? Wenlock was a wizard with bad magic. He stole a magic stick from a powerful wizard and used it to get whatever he wanted. He got stronger and stronger until no one could beat him. Please come back! No, I can't let him hurt you! Who are you? Why save me? The princess and her magic horse flew and flew away from Wenlock and to the cloud kingdom up in the sky. Lisa had never heard of such a place before. It was here that Lisa started to find out the answer to her question. We're safe here. Where is this? Kingdom in the clouds.
Huh?
I'm your elder sister, Princess Anika. It's been so long, I've almost forgotten what I look like. It's happened 17 years ago. 17 years ago, also on my birthday, Wenlock suddenly appeared. He wanted to take me as his wife. Father tried his best to refuse.
No way! Go away now, or I will lock you up in the dark jail. Huh. Hey, are you ordering me around? Yours. Let's give her a tail and wings.
Mom and Dad tried everything to break the spell, but nothing worked. I couldn't watch them get sad anymore, so I decided to leave. I kept walking and walking, and then I found the kingdom up in the clouds. The queen there let me stay. Do I really have a sister? Wow, look, we look so much alike. So that's why Mom and Dad always keep me inside all the time. I'm so sorry for being mad at them. It's all my fault. Another victim of Wenlock. What did he do this time? This is Queen Preta, who helped me. It's an honor to meet you, Queen. My mom and dad, everyone, he turned them all into ice. I have to marry him in 3 days if I want him to break the spell. I'm sorry for what he did to your kingdom. Queen, there must be some way to stop Wenlock and break the spell. Over the years, Wenlock has done many bad things. He sold a beautiful young girl to be his wife and cursed anyone who prevents him. Over the years, lots of people trying to stop the bad guy and make him pay, but none of them could because he had a special magic stick. No, impossible! Wilfrin said Lisa go back and marry Wenlock to save her mom and dad and everyone else?
Long, long ago, there was a vast land called Fairytopia, where was the perfect place for fairies to live. From forest fairies with magical wings or mermaids with graceful tails. They lived together in harmony and friendship, working together to build a beautiful world. But Lavarna doesn't think so. She had a big plan. She wanted to bring all the fairies in Fairytopia together and make them bow down to her and follow her rules. Luckily, Alina, a brave fairy with wings, found out about the bad plan in time and stopped it. After that, her wings were taken away and she was locked up in a house in a swamp, where her dark magic could be controlled. Nobody thought Lavarna was so tricky. She cooked up some really yucky poison from bad mushrooms and sent her missions to do. Also, she could come back again. You won't get away with this. You poison froze. Poison frogs? No, no! Those two idiots are the poisonous mushrooms. And you call me Big Brother. Max, Big Brother? Max, have you heard? I will never take you to the powerful berry. I like stubborn prisoners who make my job more fun. This queen stick, I see that too. Just one drop, spreading from land to water, will destroy all living things in touches. Is that enough for you to consider taking me there? Haha! Never! Oh, it's so tough! Look! Tick-tock, tick-tock. There's not much time left until it spreads into the sea and destroys the Who Underwater Kingdom. I guess it's about 5 seconds, 4 seconds, 3 seconds. Stop, okay? I will take you to fight the berry, but you must promise to leave the kingdom of Maymedia alone. Choose well, little fish.
Max? Huh? Max? Poisonous frog, have you caught the prince yet?
Of course, my queen. And you can't just sit there and eat it.
We won't be hurt by any magic. No matter if they're from the past, happening now, or in the future, we won't have to stay in that smelly but filled swarm anymore.
To protect Mermaidia, underwater palace, and all fish people, Prince Finn had to listen to the three poisonous frogs. His only hope was that the message for help he sent to Lenina, the fairy who defeated Lavarna many years ago.
No way! This can't be happening! She's supposed to be stuck in the swamp. I don't know what happened. I just walked past the rocky place, and then Prince Fink was gone. The three poisonous frogs must have taken him. You need to see this with your own eyes. No, you should stay at Mia's house. This is not safe for a little girl.
Lenina flew all by herself to a rocky place near the ocean. She could easily see the strange blue pool that had been poisoned.
Look at this scary pond. It's been poisoned. What Mia says is true. We have to find Prince Fing fast, or Lavina's bad plan will happen. Fing! Finn! Where have you been gone for so long? You dare to let me climb the tree, so don't blame me. Who is that? That's Maria, a friend of that princess. What are you doing here, Maria? I told you this is too dangerous. Please go home quickly.
Huh?
Hello, I'm Lena. I'm also Finn's friend. Huh? I thought you very beautiful, but it's actually not what I thought. What?
Huh.
Listen, I know you, but Finn and I are dating here. Could you please give us some space? Dating? Finn has been taken by the poisoned frogs. I need to help him. Or fairy Toby will completely fall under Lavina's feet. What? The poisonous frogs dared to take Finn, so I will save him. Wait, let's go together. I will do this by myself. Anyway, your fairy can breathe underwater. I have a way. You are still not back home, Maria. This sweet let me breathe underwater. That's how I get to play with my fisherman friend whenever I want. Can I come with you? I really want to have stopped loving her too. Please. Alright, but you have to stay close to me. Hurry up. If you want to come with me, you need to move faster.
The three went diving into the ocean together. They swam deeper and deeper, but they still couldn't find Prince Finn.
Oh no, the ocean is too big to find the friends this way. What should we do then? Follow me. When I was little and got lost playing, my parents would find me using this special shell. The fisherman family really respect the pearl goddess, and her magical pearl can show us when to find the friends. Wow. Oh, hello. Little Curry has grown into such a beautiful girl. You're not lost anymore, are you? Little one. Hi, Grandma. I came here, little girl. You don't belong here, but I sense a deep connection to the ocean within you. If you seek what you desire, you must be prepared to pay a hefty price. What's wrong? What did I just say? Please tell me where Prince Finn is. The poisonous frog took him away, and I need to save him. I know, but I can't tell you. If you want to find Prince Finn, you must first prove your abilities. Let's go to the Desperate Depth and find the magic mirror. Desperate Depth? It's called like that because no one who has gone there has ever returned. If you're scared, go home. I'll find the friends. To be successful, you must know how to rely on each other. And you must be willing to make sacrifice. Sacrifice what? The Desperate Depths are very dangerous. You need to be strong enough to swim underwater to get there. That strength comes from your tail, not your wings. But I don't have a tail. So, you must make a sacrifice. Trade your wings for a tail and go save the friends. Oh. Give up my wings? But can I get them back when I'm done? This isn't right. How can a fairy live without her wings? It's up to you. Think about it. I can only give you one gift. If you ever need it, use it to opt for a tail. Give up my wings? No way. Maybe she just wants to test it like a test. If we have to go down to the abyss, I have very strong tail. Don't worry. Oh yeah, you might be right. That's how it usually goes in fairy tales.
In no time at all, the Desperate Depths appear before the two girls. At first glance, they look very friendly, even somewhat beautiful.
Desperate Depth, we are right. Wow, this place looks more like a place of hope than despair. I've never seen anything so beautiful that was all so desperate. I don't know either. No one has ever escaped from here to tell us what's inside. Do you think the god of Perth were telling the truth about the magic mirror? We have to believe her. This is the only clue to finding Finn. Ready? Follow closely behind me, Maria. Let's get started. I don't understand why everyone makes such a big deal about this place. It's not that bad. It's probably just a story to scare kids into staying close to home. I think the current is pretty strong here, don't you see? Huh? Strong? It's not strong at all. You just need to swim a little harder. I swam as hard as I could, Korea. Wait a minute. I can swim that fast, Korea. Korea. So, you stay up there. I'll get the mirror. I can do it. Don't worry. Korea! Save me! I need to help Lena.
Will Caria be able to save herself from the disparate thefts? What will Lenya do in this situation? What will happen to Prince Finn and the land of Fairytopia? Find out in the next part of the story, The Mermaid Without a Tail and the Deep Sea Fairy Tale.
Flora stepped through a time door that took her to a world she had never seen before. It was a place that she never thought could be real.
Hey!
Where is this? Van, impossible! Oh, Nick, you too! What's going on? Everything is too real to be a dream.
That's right. There is no dream. We've traveled through time to my world.
Is this true? Are you saying you tricked me? Did you hug all pirate fairies in a mean way?
It's not like that. Flora, please listen to my explanation.
I must make you pay.
Stop. You're not allowed to use weapons to attack this man.
Like this?
Come with us to the station to resolve this issue.
Let me out! Quickly, you strange people!
We can't find any information about her. Maybe that lady is mentally ill. Look at her clothes. Poor thing.
Flora had to calm down in this situation. Charlie was feeling very confused and worried. After all the trouble that the pirate fairies were facing seemed to be caused by his arrival. And Charlie had the chance to explain everything. Actually, Charlie was a young and talented scientist. He was devoted to the organization. One day, Charlie found out that the organization he thought was good was actually planning something very bad. They wanted to use Charlie's time machine to mess up his story. They wanted to go back in time and take all the good stuff for themselves. Charlie could not let that happen, so he traveled through time and hit all the machines he made in Flora time period in the Caribbean Sea so that no one could find them. When Flora found out what was happening, even though she did not trust Charlie, she knew that he was the only one who could save her. Don't get your hopes up, I don't trust you. You are the reason the pirate fairies had problems.
I know, please give me a chance to make things right. I don't understand why the oil spill happened, but I can fix it.
How?
Matthew, the bad guy I told you about, still has a copy of the machine I was working on. If we can get that copy, we can use it to go back to the time before the pirate fairies happened. We can fix all mistakes.
As quickly as the flash, the pirate fairy appeared boldly in front of Matthew. Hate you. But Bali, it's time to give back the USB drive.
Do you want this? Then come here and take it.
Flora became the first female pirate for a reason. Even though she was small, she could pick up the bad guys with just a few bunches.
Hey, kiddo, that's too much trouble.
Okay, I'm sorry. I know it's my fault. It's because someone told me to do it.
Huh?
Who?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Maybe a person who have wings.
Huh? Oh!
Hurry up! Open the time door quickly! He's almost here!
Wait! I need to make a copy before we can use it!
This is troublesome!
Goodbye, Big Belly Matthew.
Huh?
No, you brass.
Charlie finally fixed the time door and was ready to open it again to go back in time to before the pirate fairy family had problems.
Ow!
Hey! Mm-hmm.
Isn't that Joseph?
Huh?
Joseph was the bad guy who caused all the trouble for the pirate fairies. He didn't like how Plora was in charge. He wanted the pirates to steal from the citizens and keep everything for themselves. When Charlie came along, he saw a chance to cause trouble and plump Charlie. Just in time to stop Joseph backflying, the efforts of humans and fairies from two different eras saved many pirate fairies and other lands from danger. I'm sorry, Charlie. I'm sorry. I didn't trust you until the very end.
No, Pirate Queen. I'm the one who causes all the problems. Thank you for giving me a chance to make things right. What are they saying? Probably angry at each other.
Not many people the timeless story of the two of them, Charlie and Flora. It's time for them to say goodbye. But with that time traveling treasure, a secret friendship across time still exists between them.
The ground suddenly shook violently, cracking open into large fissures. The people of Grinkerland had never witnessed such a terrifying sight. Everyone scrambled to escape. Everything seemed to collapse before their eyes. What was happening? It all began 3 months ago. Tambar was a cheerful and active teenager. Like many boys in this land, being enrolled in the guard team protecting Grinkerland was Tambar's pride. However, training to be selected as an official guard was not an easy process.
Come on, Tambar. Try to hold the sword for at least half the match. Oops, no apologies, okay?
Hey, kid. How long do you plan to stay at the bottom? I've never seen anyone stuck in this position as long as you.
Although Tambar was cheerful and active, he could not avoid feeling sad and disappointed in himself at times. Whenever he felt down, he would go into the forest alone to clear his mind.
What should I do? I try my best, but I'm not even half as good as them. Could it be that I can never become an official guard? What is this? So strange!
Wow!
Huh? Isn't this an animal footprint? What kind of creature could be this huge?
Tambar's curiosity led him to a completely mysterious place. A place not even mentioned in the epics of Grinzerland. So you're injured? Is that why you're groaning? Calm down. Take it slow. You'll be fine. You'll be fine. I will help you out of this pain. Okay? It just got startled. Anyone would react like that when in pain. It won't chase me, will it? Since returning home, Tambar couldn't shake off his concerns. A series of questions arose in his mind.
What is that creature? Is his leg okay now? Why did it appear here?
Once again, curiosity led Tambar to a bold decision.
Remember me? I'm not a bad person. I healed your injured leg.
To his surprise, the creature seemed to understand Tambar's words.
All right. Big Bear. I will call you Big Bear, okay?
From then on, over time, a special friendship formed between Tambar and Big Bear in secret. Tambar often visited, bringing delicious food. To Big Bear, Tambar was the only friend. But frequently, going into the forest and skipping training got Tambar into trouble.
I can give you a chance, but I cannot accept your playful attitude and neglect of training. Punish him by confining him to his room to copy the rules and not allowing him to step outside.
Tambar was confined to his room for many days without being able to say goodbye to Big Bear. The poor creature waited for Tambar for many days. Then, in its innocence, Big Bear did something bold, inadvertently putting itself in danger. What awaits Big Bear and Tambar ahead? All will be revealed in the next episode of the animated series, The Awakening Monster.
Once upon a time, there was a mighty kingdom atop a high mountain. This place possessed a colossal treasure and was ruled by a wise and kind king. The king had a passion for hunting, but little did he know that it would lead his kingdom to face an ancient curse. The king has a beautiful daughter named Dahlia. One day, like any other day, he bid farewell to his daughter and set off on a hunting trip.
Dahlia, please wait for me to come back.
Be careful, Your Highness. I will wait for you to return.
The king and his guards set off on a hunting trip. Along the way, they encountered a flock of black crows.
The detestable black crows. They dare to disturb our hunting trip.
Huh?
Foolish humans, do you know what you just did?
Who? Who are you?
Your foolishness. Don't you know who is protecting you? You must pay the price for touching the sacred creature of this land.
All the people will also share the same fate. Obediently become stone gods to protect this place forever.
The Demon King cast an ancient curse upon the kingdom and all its people.
Forgive the king and the kingdom. I accept to exchange everything.
All of them?
All of them.
Okay. Those crows were originally the spirits that I sent to protect your kingdom. Now, you shall become them to pay for the mistakes of your king. You will have to guard this kingdom until you find someone with a pure heart, willing to sacrifice themselves for you. Only then will the curse be broken. If not, you will only be able to be human at night and have to watch your loved ones and the kingdom perish forever.
The Demon King disappeared, leaving Dahlia in despair. Everyone around has turned into stone. The scenery is immersed in darkness. 10 years later, the prosperous land of Azkaban is now only known as the Kingdom of Stone. Those who come here only hope to find treasure, but no one succeeds and returns. Dahlia, now a beautiful young woman, is still imprisoned in a curse. People tell each other stories about the mysterious kingdom.
I heard there are a lot of treasures up there.
But have you seen it with your own eyes?
Just go up there and try to find it.
How long has it been?
Don't be sad, Dahlia. We will overcome this together.
Thank you, Corvus.
For the past 10 years, Corvus has been Dahlia's only friend. It has always been by her side and encouraged her.
Hello, beautiful little duckling. Please accept this rose as a replacement for my greeting.
Form when night comes. During the days, as you can see, I am a cute little crow.
There is another bandit going up the mountain today. We heard that they are very fierce and dangerous.
Hopefully they will not cause any harm to the kingdom.
Is anyone there? Huh? Help! Help me!
Pull him up.
But Princess, he could be the villain.
We cannot leave him here. Corvus, help me out. Hey, can you hear me? Hey.
I am, Carl. Hey, what are you doing?
Hurry up and disappear. Don't bother us.
Inside the castle now looks like a pile of ruins. Carl is so engrossed in admiring beautiful people that he forgets someone is still waiting for a chance to chase him away.
This unbeatable man! Get back to your place now!
Huh?
This crow is my friend.
Carl introduces himself as an adventurer. Unfortunately, he had an accident while climbing the mountain. Luckily, he was rescued by a princess. So every day when night falls, Dahlia always comes to Carl's side. The two gradually develop feelings for each other. Of course, Corvus still protects Dahlia from the person it hates. Leave
cave with me, Dahlia. Do you have something to tell me? Speak up, we will solve it together.
There's nothing here. It's just that we can't leave this place.
Princess, why don't you tell Carl the truth?
I don't want anyone to sacrifice for me. I don't want to repeat that again.
Although I hate him, Carl seems to be a person of great influence.
I know, but I can't let him risk his life.
Corvus is silent, understanding Dahlia's heart.
Princess, you should run away!
Run? You won't be able to run at all.
What will happen to Dahlia and Carl's love? Will Dahlia and the kingdom's curse be broken? Let's wait for the next part of the movie together.